giving 3-4.
Thank you.
depth.
Cancel the sugar.
much.
Good evening. I didn't hear you. Good evening.
Good evening.
It is my honor to welcome you to Candlelight Vespers, and we're going to do so by standing and singing
O come all ye faithful. Please be seated. Christmas and Hanukkah share a spiritual message that is possible to bring light and hope in a world of darkness, oppression, and despair. Where Christmas focuses on the birth of a single individual whose life and mission was itself supposed to bring liberation, Hanukkah is about a national liberation struggle involving an entire people who seek to remake the world. And it's within this context I ask you to bow your heads as we pray. Gracious and loving, merciful God, at this Vesper service, as the light of your word penetrates our hearts, as we are reminded of the gift of life and faith, as the glories of the heavenly host are echoed in our chapel, we open ourselves up to your spirit and give your thanks, and we pray, blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who has sanctified us with his commandments and commanded us to kindle the Hanukkah light. We're also grateful to remember that wondrous moment when Jesus was born. That story has become our story, and we celebrate his birth. Continue, we pray, to instill in us a profound sense of our abiding presence and help us to take to heart the wonder of your love, that we may walk in your ways and delight in your will. Help us, God, to renounce fear and build in us trust in one another. Allow us to be the faithful, gracious, loving, giving, and forgiving people you would have us be. May the peace and joy of Hanukkah and Christmas be alive in your hearts this night and forever. Amen. And as Akshay comes forward, I'm going to do my best to light our
Our first scripture reading this evening is taken from the First Testament, Book of Isaiah. Those who walked in the dark have seen a bright light, and it shines upon everyone who lives in the land of darkest shadows. A child has been born for us. We have been given a son who will be our ruler. His names will be Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God, Eternal Father and Prince of Peace. His power will never end. Peace will last forever. He will rule David's kingdom and make it grow strong. He will always rule with honesty and justice. The Lord all-powerful will make certain that all of this is done. Here ends the first reading.
Our second reading comes from a leading 20th century civil rights leader, author, theologian, and Baptist minister named Howard Thurman. He served as dean of the chapel at Howard University in the 1930s and 40s, and as dean of chapel at Boston University in the 1950s and 60s, where he was named a mentor to a young graduate student named Martin Luther King Jr. Thurman writes, "I am surrounded by the love of God. The earth beneath my feet is the great womb out of which the life upon which my body depends comes in utter abundance. There is at work in the soil a mystery by which the death of one seed is reborn a thousandfold in newness of life. The magic of wind, sun, and rain creates a climate that nourishes every living thing. It is law, and more than law, it is order. And more than order, there is a brooding tenderness out of which it all comes. In the contemplation of the earth, I know that I am surrounded by the love of God." Here ends the second reading.
Thank you. Our third reading this evening comes from Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, who suffered through a very difficult period. In 1861, his wife died in a fire. Next, the Civil War broke out in that same year, and then his son Charles snuck off to join the Union Army against his father's wishes. Within 6 months of joining the fight, Charles Appleton Longfellow was seriously wounded in that same Civil War. Sitting down to his desk on Christmas Day, 1863, President Lincoln had just been reelected and he heard the church bells ringing. It was in this context that Longfellow wrote, "I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familial carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth and goodwill to men. Till, ringing, singing on its way, the world revolved from night to day. A voice, a chime, a chant sublime, of peace on earth, goodwill to men. It was as if an earthquake rent the hearthstones of a continent and made forlorn the households born, of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair, I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said. For hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail, with peace on earth, goodwill to men." Here ends the third reading.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. We're dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Hey, 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 bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. Oh, what fun it is to sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. A day or two ago, I thought I'd take a ride. And soon this Fanny Price was seated by my side. The horse was lean and lank. Misfortune seemed his lot. He got into a drifting bank, and then we got upset.
Upset?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jing, jangle. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jing, jangle. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jing, jangle. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jing, jangle. Jingle, 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 all the way. Thank you.
Our fourth reading is from the second chapter of the Gospel according to Luke. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. Here ends the fourth reading.
Our fifth reading for this evening is taken from the second chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'By you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the young child. And when you have found him, bring word back to me that I may come and worship him also." And when they heard the king, they departed. And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into this house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. Here ends the fifth reading.
The sixth reading tonight is Christmas customs. The birth of Jesus changed the world forever. The angel's message of peace and goodwill has echoed down through the centuries. The good tidings of great joy have shaped the lives of countless thousands. Through the centuries, as each generation in each country has celebrated Christmas, customs and traditions have evolved. In the beginning, Christians brought plants and flowers into the celebration of Christmas. The poinsettia, with its bright star-like flowers, is a reminder of the Star of Bethlehem. The Christmas tree has been the subject of stories by such renowned authors as Charles Dickens, Hans Christian Andersen, and Samuel T. Coleridge. Robert Frost once wrote that he wished he could send one of his trees in a letter to wish a friend a Merry Christmas. In most villages, there was a church, and most churches had a bell. When something important was happening, such as remembering the birth of Jesus, the villagers would ring the church bell. And of course, we all know that every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings. One of our Christmas customs at Petty is to spend some time during this vesper service acknowledging the very custom, religious and not so religious, ways the world has come to celebrate this holiday. And through it all, our sincerest wish is for everyone, no matter your outlook, to welcome the light of this special season into your home. This ends the sixth reading.
Says be Our seventh reading begins with a letter from a young girl named Virginia, who lived in the last decade of the 19th century on the Upper West Side of Manhattan. She wrote this letter at the suggestion of her dad to the editor of a daily newspaper called The Sun. The editor, Francis Church, wrote a quick response that has become history's most reprinted newspaper editorial, appearing in dozens of languages, in books, movies, as well as on posters and stamps. Virginia's letter begins, "Dear editor, I am 8 years old. Some of my little friends say there is no Santa Claus. Papa says, if you see it in the newspaper, it must be true. Please tell me the truth. Is there a Santa Claus? Virginia O'Hanlon, 115 West 95th Street." Virginia, your little friends are wrong. They have been affected by the skepticism of a skeptical age. They do not believe except what they see. They think that nothing can be which is not comprehensible by their little minds. All minds, Virginia, are little. In this great universe of ours, we are a mere insect, an ant, as compared with the boundless world of truth and knowledge. Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus. He exists as certainly as love and generosity and devotion exist, and you know that they abound and give to your life its highest beauty and joy. Alas, how dreary would be the world if there was no Santa Claus. It would be as dreary as if there were no Virginias. There would be no childlike faith then, no poetry, no romance to make tolerable this existence. The eternal light with which childhood fills the world would be extinguished. Not believe in Santa Claus? You might not as well believe in fairies. You might get your papa to hire men to watch in all the chimneys on Christmas Eve to catch Santa Claus. But even if they did not see Santa Claus coming down, what would that prove? Nobody sees Santa Claus, but that is no sign that there isn't a Santa Claus. The most real things in this world are those that neither children nor anyone can see. Did you ever see fairies dancing on the lawn? Of course not. But that is no proof that they are not there. Nobody can conceive or imagine all the wonders in the world. You may tear apart the baby's rattle and see what makes the noise inside, but there is a veil covering the unseen world, which not the strongest man, nor even the united strength of all the strongest men that ever lived, could tear apart. Only faith, poetry, love, and romance can push aside that curtain and view the beauty and glory that lies beyond. Is it all real? Ah, Virginia. In all this world, there is nothing else real and abiding. No Santa Claus? Thank God. He lives and he lives forever. 1,000 years from now, Virginia, nay, 10 times 10,000 years from now, he will continue to make glad the heart of childhood. Here ends the seventh reading.
Yeah. You guys get up right where we were? They will absolutely hear you in the North Pole. just come down there. Well, we got a couple more. This is exciting. All right, the screen, whenever you're ready. It's the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a
mouse.
Oh, louder, louder.
Mouse.
Ah. Oh. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that Saint Nick soon would be
there.
Yeah. You must be all petty students. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their
heads.
That's it. Oh, this is such a big book. I can't turn the pages. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the
sash.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects.
Yeah.
When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and a tiny
reindeer.
Yes. With the little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be Saint
Nick.
Who's that, me? More rapid than eagles, his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by
name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and
Blitzen.
Oh, you guys are so smart, I don't even remember their names. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away.
Oh.
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the
sky.
So up to the housetop, the coursers, they flew with a sleigh full of toys and that's right. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little as I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a
bang.
Wow. You didn't know I could fit through a chimney, did you? He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and yes, bundle of toys he had flung on his back. And he looked like a peddler just opening his
sack.
His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses and his nose like a
cherry.
Yes. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as
snow.
Yes. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a
wreath.
Well, you know all of this. He had a broad face and a round, big belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of
jelly.
Yes. No. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of
myself.
Yes. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to
dread.
Oh, that's a big word. That's an SAT word, I think. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod up the chimney, he sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a one more page. But I heard him explain ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all and
to all of you."
Oh, wonderful.
Our ninth and final reading this evening is an excerpt from Charles Dickens' 19th century novella about a bitter old man named Ebenezer Scrooge and his transformation on Christmas morning, A Christmas Carol. I will live in the past, the present, and the future, Scrooge repeated as he scrambled out of bed. The spirits of all three shall strive within me. I don't know what to do, cried Scrooge, laughing and crying in the same breath. I am as light as a feather. I am as happy as an angel. I am as merry as a schoolboy. I am as giddy as a drunken man. A Merry Christmas to everybody, a Happy New Year to all the world. He went to church and walked about the streets and watched the people hurrying to and fro and patted children on the head and found that everything could yield him pleasure. He had never dreamed that any walk, that anything, could give him so much happiness. Some people laughed to see the alteration in him, but he let them laugh, and little heeded them, for he was wise enough to know that nothing ever happened on this globe for good, at which some people did not have their fill of laughter in the outset. His own heart laughed, and that was quite enough for him, and it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well, if any man alive possessed the knowledge. May that be truly said of us and all of us. And so, as Tiny Tim observed, God bless us, everyone. On behalf of the entire Pay School community, it is my honor to wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas. Let us now stand and sing Silent Night.
Thank you.
fragile Savior, you come unprotected into our dangerous world and offer yourself as our peace. Let our joy be to seek your peace. Let our hope be to foster your peace. Let our purpose be to announce your peace with all the fervor of the angels and all the courage of the poor. Glory to God in the highest and on earth. God's peace. Amen. You can extinguish your candles. And it is a tradition here at Petty as we end the service to sing the Hallelujah Chorus. We invite anyone who wants to come forward, like Mr. Harris, who's already on his way. Come on up and sing.
God, there's a spider. Hallelujah. Oh, yes.